My name is Hussein Jawad. I am the chairman of the European Bahraini Organization for Human Rights, and I'm a member of Frontline Defenders. We came to France from August, the last August, because of because I'm targeted in Bahrain. I'm facing a lot of cases against me. It's about freedom of expression. And I am sentenced from last December 2 years of imprisonment. So that's why I came to France to seek political asylum. Actually, there is a charge against me. It's about insulting the king and incited hatred against the regime because of a speech I have given in the capital of Bahrain when there is an event about religious event it was about. So I take this moment to talk about the human rights violations in Bahrain. So after that, I was arrested, and several times I was arrested before and after, and I was tortured. So that's why I am facing a lot of cases, even a case about freedom of expression in a Twitter, about the tweets. Actually, the human rights issues in Bahrain is in general is very bad. It's getting worse because of the double standards that the European countries or Saudi Arabia or the US have or the United Kingdom have about Bahrain. I want to see that the torture and the political prisoner and the children will be out of a prison, and there is a lot and there is a huge number of children who were arrested and being beaten and tortured inside the prison, and this is the main cases that we want to stop in Bahrain. Because of illegal gathering, because of they raise their voices and they raise their they demand political reforms with the demonstrations and the when they go out of their houses to demand political reform. No, it's the same, but the younger generation is very, they are very more strong and they have courage and they have faith more and they want to change the situation in Bahrain. So because of the beginning of the revolution was all of them, they were young and all of them, they were like youth. So that's why they want to change and they want to push for political reform and the human rights. There is no a real media coverage when there is a lot of coverage about Syria, about Libya, about Tunisia, about different kind of countries. So we said that we have to push the European governments or the European countries to ask the Bahraini government directly and frankly to change the situation in Bahrain, and we know that they have a good influence on that. All the human rights defenders, especially in the Europe, we have faith on them and we know that they can change with their voices. So we want them to change, we want them to push their governments to send letters, to talk on media, to stand on demonstrations against the Bahraini and Saudi governments, that they are executing people and they are torturing human rights defenders and activists and bloggers and clerks and all of them. we ask them to stand up with us and support us. There is no sectarian problem. There is a political problem. There is a human rights cases. Is I don't know how to say it in English, but there is a human rights violations that they have to be stopped. So if we have a sectarian problem, that you will see a lot of Shias or Sunnis are fighting together. Why there is any kind, there is no any kind of fighting between Sunnah and Shia in Bahrain. If you will see the pictures or the videos in YouTube or in Twitter or on the social media, you will see there is a people are trying to demand a political reform, and there is a clashes between people and the police, not Sunnah and Shia. Before, the Bahraini government say no, there is no torture in Bahrain. When I went through this, and a lot of international organizations, they issues statements and reports about my case as a human rights defender and as a chairman of a human rights organization. So it was a huge different image to Bahrain, and I think they are they don't feel good because they did this to me. But my torture issue from my case was raised in internationally, especially in the media, the European media, this kind of newspapers and TVs. So that affects in a good way the Bahraini image. That what Bahrain want to say about their torture. So my case was one of the strongest cases that says there is a torture in Bahrain. So after that, in the court, lots of embassies they attend, lots of organizations they attend. I talked about my experience. I talked about torture in Bahrain, and I hoped that after my case, they will stop the torture. But I don't think so, because they are using this kind of interrogation to sign a false confessions and to say wrong things about what the activists did or what they are doing. It's revenge from our work. And for our work, they want to stop us. They want to push us to stop tweeting. They want to push us stop talking to media. They want to push us to stop writing reports and document cases. To stop us to cover any kind of violations in the street. What's happening every day in daily basis in Bahrain. But this is wrong. That all the governments, all the crazy governments that they think torture or arrest or like banning human rights defenders from travel, that will not show the real face of the country, it's not right. Actually, what I see in the future of Bahrain is a little bit I don't know how to say it, it's a little bit what you call it, الأحباط? Yeah, it's a disappointment what I see of the future of Bahrain, but I hope it will be better with our work, with the human rights defenders' work, with the media coverage. We tried our best to change this kind of situation, but for sure we have to be very to have a hope to change the situation, and we have to work, and we have to push everyone and every organization that can support our people and support our struggle and support our work in Bahrain.